deal. I'm just, my opinion is worthless, and my opinion means something to me. I'm the guy that your mom and dad would say, this guy, I don't want his records in the house. Which is perfect for me, you know? No, I'm not really an outlaw. I just want to do things my way. Like, the biggest mistake my old man ever made was buying me an FM radio, right? When FM came out in 68. I mean, like, that was important. More than a guitar.
John Cougar was born in Indiana in 1952, and like many others raised on radio in the heartland of America, he was fed a musical diet of Motown soul and rock and roll. With a life so infused with music, it was only a matter of time before he took off to find his place in the world of rock. 1975 found him in New York City with a demo tape, a drive to make it big, and a bit of a reputation as a troublemaker.
I came to New York for the first time when I got out of college, and I got hooked up with a guy who said, listen, man, I took David Jones to David Bowie, and I changed his name, and it was because that was one of the reasons he's so successful. So I'm going to do the same for you. Because I went and looked at the album cover, and there was, like, this name on the album cover, my picture, and I was like, who's this fool? You know, that ain't my name. I want my, he says, I can't sell a guy named John Mellencamp. I could sell John Cougar. And I said, well, forget it then. I'm not interested. He said, great, go back and pour concrete, which is what you were doing.
Cougar did not go back to pouring concrete. Instead, he returned to Indiana to begin work on new material. Within months, he had a contract with Rod Stewart's label, Riva Records. It wasn't long before an album simply entitled John Cougar was finding its way on the charts and on the airwaves. His next album, Nothing Matters and What If It Did, featured two of his most popular songs. This time...
This time I really think I'm in love, I'm in love. This time I think I'm really in love.
And Ain't Even Done With The Night.
All night. Well, it's time to go home. And I ain't even done with the night.
Despite his success, Cougar has remained in Indiana with his friends, determined not to lose touch with small-town life. His latest album is called American Fool.
Yeah, you know, it's just straightforward. I mean, it's two guitars, bass, and drums. And to me, to go back to that is exciting. To go back to that format is exciting. Because, I mean, if I hear one more synthesizer go, I'm gonna puke, you know, to be honest with you. So I want things to be easy and fun again, you know, at least for me. And that's exciting to me.
Are your songs autobiographical?
My songs are just, I write about very insignificant parts of life. And so I guess, yeah, because they happen to everybody. I'm interested in the real thing. A farmer sitting on a plow, 70 years old, that guy's got something to say to you. You know, because he's been around, he's lived. But, you know, I don't want to hear about somebody's next record coming out. Well, I got a new album coming out.
What's a favorite song that you've ever written? What's your particular choice?
I haven't written that song yet. I'm still waiting for me to write my favorite song. You know, I've got a lot of favorite songs that I get excited about when I hear by other people. Hey, I'm a fan. I've always been a record fan, even though I feel like rock and roll is kind of a dinosaur these days.
So in a way, in your own way, you're a bit of an outlaw. You don't intentionally go out to do that just because you sort of go around.
I play the game. Don't ever think I don't play the game, because we all play the game. We all got bosses. And the minute you start thinking you're free is when you're in trouble. Because then you're living a lie. I know who my bosses are, and I know what game I got to play with them. So I'm not an outlaw. I just want to do things my way. You know, you start out like this, and you're going on this path, and then people get you off of it. So the closer you can keep in the path of least resistance is the path I want to travel.
Well, you spent quite a bit of time as an opening act on the road. Did you find that tough to, you know,
audience? There's no free rides, you know. I think that anybody that comes out, and I think you'll attest to this too, anybody that comes out and automatically, boom, they're like playing to 20,000 people. 2 years, they're not playing to nobody. You know, I think you got to work. I've been making records for 8 years, and I think that by me working all these years and seeing it, I've learned the business. I've got a job when I can't make records anymore, because I know the business. I've learned about, you know, what it takes to get a record on the radio, what it takes to get an artist in front of people, And I've learned the business. So when all of a sudden I'm bored or the public doesn't want to see me or whatever, I got another job to go to. And that's what it is job security. I mean, let's make the best of the situation.
A lot of people haven't seen you actually perform live, but from what I understand, you really like to get into the audience and just, you know, get in there and mix with them. Are you afraid that you'd ever get hurt, like doing
Oh, I've been hurt a lot. I got knocked out in Detroit, had to go to the hospital. That was fun. I mean, you know, there's something to be said about innocence, jumping out in the audience and that kind of stuff when you're young. But I don't know anymore about, I mean, I feel now that all I care about is if the band and I are having a good time, that's good enough, because that will reflect into the audience, right? The audience will see us. But always before, I was interested in the audience having fun. I'm not saying I don't care about the audience anymore, but I'm saying it's more important for me to have a good time now than it is for the, you know, because if I have a good time, the audience will have a good time.
Well, all right, you're back. We could stay half a day, or we could run around all night. Well, all night, all night. Well, it's time to go home, and I ain't gonna know it tonight.
What is your goal within yourself? Do you have anything that you really want to go for, your statement, anything?
To be happy. That's my statement. You know, that's what this is all about. I mean, I'm not in the rock and roll business to be rich and famous, because, you know, money and cars, and that's all fine, you know, but it's not going to make you happy. Anything you got to pick up or take or put in your nose, that's not happiness, you know. But when you, like, I haven't been drunk for 10 years. Can you believe that? I haven't taken drugs for 10 years. Now, can you believe, you know those guys that used to walk around like this? You see them walk around? That was me, you know? And I see my friends that I hang around with this look on their face like, go ahead, say something to me, you know? And I thought, that's so silly, you know? And I'm like that. Am I really like that? So when I quit doing drugs and quit drinking, I found out that I wasn't like that at all. I don't want to hurt nobody. I don't want to fight with nobody. So now it's like real important to be real. And if I feel like saying something to you that might offend you, I may say it. But I expect the same from you. I don't like to be lied to, and I don't think people like to be lied to. I want to know the real truth. I want to know, no matter how disgusting or how lovely it is, I want to know the real thing. I want to know the true story.
So what do you have planned? What's going on with you now?
I don't know. I don't like to make very many plans. I know I'm going to go on tour, and I don't know the specifics of that. Because, you know, when you make plans, it's always messed up, right? I mean, you know, hey, let's go somewhere tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. Tomorrow night at 7 o'clock never seems to roll around at the right time. So I just take it as it comes.
Oh yeah, life goes on, long after the thrill of living is gone.